Welcome. Steps for today, I will discuss with you is how to create your technical file, more explanation about the requirement list, and how you can request your supplier to upload the documents you can request from him. So we now have a new help. And if you log in the system, you will find this button, help and instructions. And please take a look. There are lots of extra information, instructions, videos, bring me to the guide, and extra information. And this training are also available, of course, and extra trainings you can find on the upcoming events calendar. If you didn't find the answer, or you just need some more clarification, you can send an email to help desk. You can do it in English, then we will answer. And if you write it in German, or you're from Germany, my German colleague will respond, and you can discuss it in your own language. So that could be very helpful. So you can all in here, you can also find extra instructions like the video instructions in German and in Mandarin. The English version will come up soon. It's in progress now. So we keep on working like that. So why product compliance? It's not something Product IP has invented. It's just we invented a platform to collect all this data. Actually, it's written down in the blue guide, and you can find a lot more information here. This is the link for the English version. Here you can also find the German version and the Mandarin version, etc. But take a look. Here's explained why this is there and what you have to do and what the technical documentation is and what harmonized standards are. So extra information and a lot more detailed information for you here to find. What Product IP has done is we have invented a platform where we collect all the requirements on European level for all the articles and non-food. If you go to the Q&A, we generate a list of applicable requirements for your product, and then you can send out an invite, we call that, to your supplier. And with this invite, you grant him access to your technical file so he can upload it directly in your technical file, not in your own email, so you don't have to upload it again, or not accessible for your colleagues, etc. Then you can link the documents to the requirements, so you have an overview on how compliant your product is and what kind of documents you still have to collect. And we also monitor the legislation. So if you have a new batch and new requirements are applicable, or there are new standards for your product for your next batch, you can collect that evidence again and create a new technical file. And of course, you can share the information. You can share the whole technical file, for instance, with your customer, or you can share the information with the QR code or the URL link, use a manual shared like that, or a CE declaration, and not the whole technical file. What we also have added to our platform is the ability to hide information on, for instance, a test result. There is a test result you received from your supplier with the name of your supplier, but you don't want to share that name with your customer. So you can hide that information directly using the platform. So this is what I will explain for you today, how to create your technical file, how you will invite your supplier. And next week, I will show you how to link the documents, and the next week I show you how to share the information. One of the frequent asked questions is, does every article has its own technical file? And that's no. If it has the same supplier, same material, same requirement list, so it has the same function, and you have to collect the same document, or the articles are on the same document, actually, that's what I'm trying to say. So like here, the deviation of color, deviation of shape, size difference, this can be grouped into one technical file. You start the article from the first article, for instance, with the black one, and later, when you have created your technical file, you add the pink one to your technical file. Here you find two pens, but they are made of different material. And this is an indoor lamp, and this is an outdoor lamp. So this has different requirements are applicable to both products. So don't create one shoebox, create two technical files, and you have a perfect overview on the compliancy of your product and what requirements are applicable to your product. So when you create your technical file, and it's important to understand this point of view, is this is your technical file for this article. And then on the product information, you find the information about your product. Those are the different variations of the product. And here you find the documents applicable to every article mentioned on the product tab. And this is the information we have used to create your requirement list. So therefore, a marked release date is very important. And if you have a new batch in 2020, basically there are new requirements applicable. So you have to create a new technical file. And you see also here the regions where the requirements are based on, and the product category, and the extra Q&A you have answered. For instance, you have a flashlight, and we ask a question, because you are creating a technical file for a flashlight, do you also want to add the battery directives to this technical file? This should all be applicable to all the articles mentioned here, and all the documents should be in relation to the articles mentioned on the product tab. That's the idea of how you create your technical file. This is just a picture, you don't have to read it. The first time I opened the requirement list and I saw all the red dots and all the things she mentioned, like the standards here, I think, okay, what else do I have to do? So if you look at the requirement list, you see it's grouped together on main categories. And here you find the standards applicable to the safety of electrical safety report, etc. And those you have to find on your test results. So the thing is very important to look at is this column is what kind of documents do I have to collect? We have added a column for that. And as you can see here, once you are creating your technical file and managing it and collecting all the documents, linking the documents to the requirements, you set them to a different color. Green means fulfilled. You decide what kind of color it becomes. So green means I'm completely complying to this regulation. Sometimes you can set it to not applicable. In some cases, you leave it red because it's unfulfilled and it's something you have to be top of mind with the next batch. Or it's in progress, and there could be that you have a declaration or a certificate, but you don't have the test result at this moment. So then you set it to blue because the document is relevant, but it's not enough to set it to completely fulfilled. Then we also add the corrigendas or the corrections of the standard to our list. And that makes our list long. But if you comply to the legislation, to the standard, the ACs, you can also tick green because you're complying to that. Because 9 out of 10, it means a typo which corrected like that. We have also grouped the requirements in categories. A to B3 is legislative mandatory and is applicable to the authorities who's checking you on the compliancy. And this is about the business risk. Doesn't mean that you only have to collect for the A to B3, because here can be critical requirements for your company. In some cases, there is a transition period of the legislation. Like here, this is a requirement list for an article brought on the market before this date. And that means that you have a transition. This one is applicable until 20 of December 2020. When you bring the new batch on the market after this date, you create a new technical file, and this one will disappear from your requirement list, and only the successor will be visible for you. In this case, you have a transition period and you can choose. So you choose based on the requirements mentioned on the test result you received. In this case, I received the test result mentioning those standards. So I make those fulfilled, set those to fulfilled. And the next step would be that I declare those to not applicable, because I don't have to comply to those standards because they are only valid after 2012. No, they're valid now, but you have to comply to them after this date. So in this case, I'm fully compliant because I bring my article on the market before the 20th of December 2020. So I can comply to those legislation. So to summarize is that you will change the colors from red, preferably to green, of course, but in some cases, yellow is okay, especially when you are in a transition period and the requirements is really not applicable for your product at the moment. And here is the categories. And because we have categorized them on the risk profile, this is in every technical file, you can see in an overview how compliant your product is. And if you click on that, you can still see what's not fulfilled at this point. While you are working on your technical file, the colors of the requirement list will change. Here is a document linked to the requirement, and the document has been read by Magid. I will show you this later next week. And because the system could have read the document because it was a genuine PDF, we have highlighted the background in green that gives you some relevance or validation of the document. And here is a blue background, and that means that there's an invite and you have a request for your supplier to upload those documents. And this is just for clarification that this is an introduction in the possibility to create very quickly a CE declaration for the European countries in every European language requested. And here on the requirement list, you see what should be listed on the CE declaration. And if you have collected all this evidence, then you can create your CE declaration and then link this to the CE declaration like that. Next week, I will explain you more about CE declaration. Also, on every technical file, there's an I if you look at one tab. And here you can find a lot of interesting extra information about your specific product. Like here, you find the compliance clips. That's a very short explanation like Wikipedia written by product IP with the explanation what the declaration of product identity means and why you need it. And there's also a template, and if you want to visit or download something, you can see who is the owner of this information. But a lot of extra information you can find here also in your technical file. Okay, when you create your account, you can just go to the login page and create your account and go to the steps. Then you can add your logo to the account. So this logo will be used in the invite. So I recommend to use the logo of your account. And you can add colleagues to the account. Of course, you can do a lot more, but now I stick to the base. You always log in with your own email address and save your own password. If you have forgot your password, you can request here your new password. So the flow for creating your technical file is the first step, of course, creating the technical file, upload the documents you already have, then fulfill the requirements or declare them not applicable, and then send out the invite to your supplier and request the documents you want to collect from him. Of course, a very important step is monitor if the invite is accepted and if the documents are uploaded, and then review and link the documents and close the file. So, sounds like a very piece of cake. The next step in our Q&A is how do you want to create your technical file? You can do it all yourself. You can click on connect, and we have an office in Shenzhen where my lovely colleagues work, can get in contact with your supplier because most of the suppliers are in China, and they can communicate in their own language with your Chinese supplier how to respond on European legislation, what European legislation is, what kind of documents they have to upload. And once they have uploaded one document, that service stops because otherwise we have to review the documents, and that's in FAST, and that's file assembly support team. And we can help you creating your technical file. And especially when you have little knowledge about requirements, about test results, etc., then it could be a very first step on creating your technical file. Like here, we also have an option that you start in do it yourself, collect the documents yourself, and then upgrade your technical file to organize. You can do that with this button. And then we will review and link the documents for you and give you an update. With this update and the missing documents, you can collect them. And if you have uploaded those new missing documents to the technical file, you can start the second round and we will review those documents and link them again. And then that server stops. You can read it all in your technical file once you click on buy. So starting your technical file is, the first step is of course, buy your credits. You need 2 credits to create your technical file. And then click on create a new technical file. This information is mandatory and that's the market release date. That's the date of this new batch you bring on the market, not the market introduction date. It's always very near to the day you create your technical file or in the future, of course. And then you can add the supplier information here. You can also add the information about the article number of your supplier, because maybe your supplier has a different article number as you, so that makes it relevant, etc. And then click on next, and then you go to the Q&A. And there are a lot of extra questions, so I can't go through all the questions, but the market release date, important. What kind of countries do you sell it? Don't choose all of Europe if you only sell it in Germany and Belgium, for instance, because if there are specific requirements for instance, Denmark, it will be on your list. It will make a longer list and you don't have to comply to it because you don't sell it there. Also, an extra question is, does the product have a packaging? Because there is a packaging directive. In some cases, people want to create a technical file per packaging, but you can also add it to your technical file about the product. And extra questions is about the inspections, because inspections is not mandatory to put in a technical file, but you have to do some inspections. That's mandatory. So why not do it on a structure base in a technical file? And also about social compliance, you can add that to your technical file, but it's also not mandatory. And that's why it's in the Q&A. And then a very important one is to choose the right product category, because that determines the legislation applicable to your product. So if you choose the wrong product category, you have a wrong list. And what if your product is not on the database, because maybe you are choosing a different alias, or we haven't invented your product yet? Then choose a provisional and go to the Q&A. My colleague will be notified that there has been a technical file created with a provisional category, and he will get in contact with you and choose the right product category to your technical file. And you can get started with the right requirement list. Once you have created your technical file, and if you have chosen for a provisional, then and you have extra documentation, please add that, because that makes the life of my colleague much easier, because he knows by picture or a manual or extra information about your product what kind of product you were looking for. And otherwise, you can add them to your technical file by adding them on the document tab. The second step will be that you add your product category to your technical file. If you have different shape, different color, etc., you have multiple articles in your technical file. And then you can send out the invite to your supplier. You go to the invite tab, invite user, and if you have filled out the information about you from your supplier, it will be already filled in here. Product IP training will be, of course, your company name. You can add a message here, and you can select the documents you want to receive from your supplier and then send the invitation, and an email will be sent to your supplier. And this is what your supplier will see. Your logo will be here if you have added it to your account, of course. Your extra message you have added here will be in the information invite. And he has a start upload button. And if he clicks there, he only have to create an account if he doesn't have that already. And it's free of charge cooperation from your supplier. And also this text is in that invite. And you can see we are the help desk for your supplier, all free of charge. So if he doesn't know how to operate the system, how to upload the documents, because he doesn't see the button, etc. We will help him and guide him to perform his request from your. And this is what he will see. He will only see his upload page. And here are the documents requested from you. And that's linked to your requirement list. Like here, this is with a blue background. All those documents will be requested on the side of your supplier. And your supplier has also access to the extra information. Like here, I click on the declaration of product identity. He also can read the compliance clips or download the template to create declaration of product identity, and he can upload it them here and you can review the documents. Once you're reviewing the documents, it's possible that you reject the documents, for instance, and you can add a note while rejecting the document, and that will also be visible on the side of your supplier. So here it will be the document mentioned, and here will the document rejection also be visible for your supplier with the note why you have rejected it. Also, if it's checked, your supplier can see it on his side and it's linked and he can't delete it anymore. Documents you have added to the technical file will not be visible on the side of your supplier, of course. Only the document your supplier has uploaded are visible for your supplier. If you want to create your technical file, if you have created your technical file, you can add here extra information. For instance, your requirement, your market release date, your deadline date, etc. This kind of information you can add here to your technical file. And if you're looking at your invite and you still see it's pending, and for the first week, you can resend here the invite again as a reminder for your supplier to please accept the invite. If you're, is it still pending after 2 weeks, you have to make a phone call or Skype or contact your supplier on differently than by using the system, of course, because then he probably have not seen the email, or there's a mistake, or he doesn't get it and he doesn't want to cooperate with you with working on product IP. That's possible.